Hey guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rides, and I am at the monthly DuPont Cars and Coffee event here in almost sunny Florida. The sun's coming up early morning, walking around, and I came across this 2013 Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution. And what's really awesome, it's one of my favorites, the GSR. So if you've been living under a rock for the past couple decades, you would not know that Mitsubishi at one time was at the top of their game when it came to all-wheel drive rally car performance. Not only did they make awesome street machines like this, but they also won lots of rally championships and lots of rally races across the whole entire world. What I like about these cars is that they take the mundane Lancer, a regular A to B car, grocery getter, and they pump it full of some trickery. Some of that trickery is going to include that turbocharger and that all-wheel drive. Let's go ahead and take a look at the front of this 2013 Evo. I liked in 2008, so in 2008 is when they switched to this design. This is an Evo 10. That's a 10th generation. Obviously, it started all the way back in the late 80s, early 90s with the, actually 1992 to be exact, the Lancer Evo 1. Over time, it has gone from 1 all the way to 10. I really, really have been a big fan of the open grille. I like the metal mesh that they use. These are functional vents with the fog lights. That's like that from the factory. This owner did not add that. One thing I am happy to see is this owner, which we'll get more into in a second, has done a lot of trickery underneath the hood. Whenever you're starting off with a turbo power car, this is gonna be one of those most important things you wanna change is that intercooler. This has a front mount intercooler. The intercooler cools the air, which is gonna give you more horsepower. As you can see, I don't know if Tom, my camera guy, could show you the AMS logo. AMS is one of those companies that has done a lot of work fine-tuning and honing their craft to get more power out of these Evo engines. And what's awesome is they could take it. They hold together very well in upwards of 400, 500, 600 horsepower. Let's check out underneath the hood. So you can see underneath the hood, we continue with full AMS. He's got Wiseco pistons underneath the hood. He is in the process of doing more mods. So on the list are gonna be bigger injectors and bigger turbo. The great news is with the setup he's currently running with the cams and the pistons and the whole AMS setup, he's looking at around 350 horsepower to the wheels, which guess what? At the end of the day, that's a great balanced car, but expect more from this Evo. I do like the custom strut tower brace that reaches across the back here. That's gonna stiffen up the front of the car. Very clean, very well done. I like the direction that this owner's going. Another thing, this is one of the early, you compare this to a Subaru WRX or an STI, full aluminum hood, and this is a functional hood. These are two heat extractors, and then this center vent here is gonna bring air into the engine compartment. You can see he's running that TL blow-off valve. I love the tubing. AMS does a top-notch job with their welds. Tom, show them the welds over here on the intake, the air intake and everything. Very, very nicely done. The welds, really, really top-notch company. They're doing a lot of work now with GTRs and whatnot. Let's go ahead and work our way to the side. What he's running here are these beautiful Rotogrid T37s. Very, very nicely. I like the bronze with the gray. Gray for this car is a great color, but with these custom wheels, it really pops well with the gray. They come from the factory with four piston Brembo calipers. He decided to put some StopTech slotted rotors here, also ventilated. That's gonna not only help, you wanna do performance under the hood, you also wanna up the performance when it comes to brakes, because eventually you gotta stop. As we work our way down, one of the things that makes an Evo is the wider front fenders. This is a functional vent here on the side, but if Tom could come around and swing from the back and show you that front fender, how it protrudes a little bit more than a stock Lancer, that is something that is specific. Also, if he pans down, he could show you the lower sill here. So this lower sill is another Evo specific that is not like that on the Lancer. As we work our way out back, the owner decided to go with a carbon fiber vortex generator across the back on the roof. Also, this is a wonderful rear wing that comes from the factory. This wing is functional. You can see he's got the extra gurney strip across the back. You'd be surprised. This little strip here, you would think wouldn't do much, but at speed, it's gonna help produce even more downforce. Here's the quiz question of the day. Do you know why they call it a gurney flap? It's because of the famous racer who recently passed away, Dan Gurney. Not only was he a racer, but an engineer. He came up with that idea of putting that extra material to get more downforce. And then out back, I've always liked the back of Evo 10s. Very clean. He kept the stock taillight set up. He's running a huge AMS 3-inch exhaust outlet, single exhaust outlet, and this is a functional diffuser. So very, very nicely done. You don't have to go too crazy with these. There are different rear bumpers you could run and whatnot, but I like the look from the factory. But anyways, if you like these types of cars, these Evos, leave a comment in the comment section. If you have not hit subscribe yet, what are you waiting for? This is the type of stuff that I'm bringing. If you haven't seen my Facebook, my Instagram, or my Twitter, all Radies Rides original content all the time, check those out. I wanna thank all of you who have been subscribing. Thank you for being part of this family. It's a wonderful thing to be growing, not only with you, but just with everybody else. And I love how we start sharing comments, people across the country, across the world, helping one another. Definitely wanna give a big shout out to Tom Moschner. He's been putting in the work, not only here at the shows, he's been putting on some big work for himself, getting his arms bigger. He's entering a powerlifting competition December 1st. So definitely give him some well wishes. Definitely give him some support. And if you know anybody who has an inside connection with protein, let me know, because he's always in search of protein. So that's what he needs. Anyways, I want to thank all of you for watching. And just like always, I'll catch you on the next ride.